Bryson Booker Television. All the television you could ever want. Click and subscribe now, and more videos are soon to come. Thanks for watching. Welcome to Bryson Booker Television. And it is in July. Welcome to another episode. Today, we're going to be talking about my 1990 Burger King Simpsons toys. That was a little bright there. There. These were from 1990. From Burger King. Released by Burger King. They're part of my Simpsons collection. I am a fan of The Simpsons, and I just wanted to show you a video of these toys, since I don't see them on YouTube. Did see the commercial on YouTube, but not really of the toys themselves. But yeah, anyway, they have like a rubber head. Each of them have a rubber head, and they're kind of surprise in size. Many toys today aren't as big as these guys are. Wow. I think these came with whenever you would buy a Burger King kids meal, or on the commercial it said a BK breakfast item, you would get one of these, or a small fry. It said on the commercial you would get one. But yeah, these toys today, they really don't match up to the size of these. They pretty much look like this little Lisa, and pretty much that's what you get. But these are pretty nice toys. I only have the family of four. I don't have Maggie, the baby. For some reason, the pack I bought them on eBay, great condition on eBay too. They didn't come with the baby, and I think I already had Maggie. I think she was in my toy chest over there. Can't see it. It's dark. But, yeah. The Maggie I have is from the Burger King Simpsons toys as of 2011. Last year when they had the Halloween special. That's the Maggie I own. But, yeah, pretty much. Pretty big. Let's compare them to my jukebox. They're kind of big in size. They almost reach the top of the jukebox. Well, at least Marge does. But Bart's kind of up there. Homer's right by the CD player. And then Lisa is right there. But still, they're surprisingly big compared to other toys you get in Burger King kids' meal now. Mostly girl toys. But anyway, they all come with their little thingies, cardboard things. Like, let's take Bart's, for instance. Bart has a skateboard. He has a skateboard. Although nowadays, it would really be a slingshot. But once again, 1990, The Simpsons were first coming on the air, so really, we didn't really get to know them that well, like we do now. But yeah, this is a skateboard, and on the back of each item, it says, "Meet the Simpsons, Bart, Lisa, Homer, Maggie, and Marge. Collect all five, only at Burger King." And then it says The Simpsons, Trademark, 1990, 20th Century Fox, Matt Groening, Registered Trademark of Burger King Corporation. And then that's the old Burger King logo. So really, there's really nothing, not really a long video about these. They have like a stuffy bottom and a rubber head, which I don't get. But Lisa has her saxophone. Homer has a bowling bag. Although, really, nowadays, I thought Homer was going to have a donut. Because he likes to eat, and he likes donuts. But I guess, once again, first airing. So really, you just started to get to know him. And then Marge has a shopping bag. Maggie had a bear. A pink bear she had. Another little figures, little Simpsons figures that I started to collect were these little Playmates figures. I want to get more, but I have Sherry and Terry. They're characters in the Simpsons that really don't get recognized all the time. I don't know why I started with them. Usually a big collector who collects all the figures would leave them second to last, but they're first in my collection. And at the bottom, you could hook them into a playset. This was created by Playmates 2002. You can hook them in a playset, and they would talk. And this is a Lisa that I got from Universal Studios in Los Angeles. Bendable figure. So pretty much, that's my little toy talk about the Simpsons figures. If you're wondering where they sit, I also do have the original plastic, so if I want to store them, put them away, I have the original plastic in my toy box. And if you're wondering where they sit over here at the toy box. You really can't see them because it's really dark. Turn the light on. And the light won't help, but anyway, they sit on my toy chest. By Homer Simpson, Jack in the Box, Darth Vader, and Woody from Toy Story. So thanks for watching. And I still gotta learn to turn my camera off. I don't get it. But anyway, thanks for...
Hey everybody, it's me, Bryson Booker here. With another game review of a classic GameCube game. This is Taz Wanted. By Infra Games and Warner Brothers. Yep, Infra Games, Warner Brothers, and the Looney Tunes Corporation. Taz Wanted. What can I say about this game? I had it for such a long time. Enjoyed playing it over and over and over again. It was one of those games that you just can't get enough of. Because once you beat most of it, then you want to go back and play it again. That's the thing that you do for this, because it's a really fun game. So the theme of the game is pretty much your Taz. Yosemite Sam pretty much wants to attack Taz and capture him and put him in a zoo. And what you have to do is pretty much you have to break out. And pretty much your Taz. And you go to through these different worlds with different challenges you have to complete to destroy all of the Taz Wanted stickers loaded up around that world. There are a total about 5 worlds on this game, all of which pretty much I've been through. I think I'm on the 4th world. You see, my GameCube games, I got more advanced systems now. PS, aka Xbox 360, so I don't really play these GameCube games much anymore. But while I'm here at the house, my house, I like to play them sometimes, and sometimes I forget how far I got on them. Like on this one, I actually got to the 4th world before the last world, so like I said, almost beat it. I got 2 profiles on this game. So, I have played it again before. But pretty much, yeah, you're Taz, and you go through all these nice different worlds, and you, once again, destroy all of the Taz Wanted stickers. And here's some scenes from the game. I actually made it through half of these worlds. The game features include spin, smack, burp, and bounce through more than 15 destructible levels. Yes, there are a lot of levels in this game. Chow down on peculiar power-ups like hiccup soda, mega hot chili peppers, which pretty much will make you burp fire. That's what those are for. Blistering speed, spectacular graphics, puzzles, and fluffy, interactive, and fully interactive environments. I thought that said fluffy. Fully interactive environments. And, were hilarious disguises to avoid the Taz catchers. So, throughout the levels, you have these guys in blue suits with nets, and they're pretty much out to catch Taz. So you have to try to avoid them, and with these disguises, you can either smack them in the face or do something silly that'll make them faint for a minute, but then they'll get back up again. Compete against friends in multiplayer mode. So yes, this does have multiplayer mode, two-player, and pretty much multiplayer mode, you either play as Taz or the She-Devil. Only two characters you can really play as. Great game. 2002. Really nice game. Like, it's fun. It's a fun game, I gotta admit. Destroying stuff. Who wouldn't want to do that? For pretty much most of the game. And it also has a nice story plot along with it. So, with all the Looney Tunes characters, most of all of them make an appearance in the game. Great game. Infra Games 2002 with Warner Brothers. And, hope you play it. Really nice game. Thanks for watching. Hey, buddy. It's me, Bryson Booker. Here to do a review on a classic Nickelodeon VHS from its golden age, 1993. And this is a classic Nicktoon called The Ren and Stimpy Show. A great, great show while it was on the air. And this is volume 2 in the 3-volume video collection called The Stupidest Stories. I also am going to be doing a review on volume 3, which was The Stinkiest Stories, but I do not have volume 1. But I do have another Ren and Stimpy VHS called Ren and Stimpy in Disguise. I will be doing a video on also. But anyway, here is the 1993 video released by Sony Wonder and Nickelodeon. Three Twisted Tales. And it says, a stupid bonus. Stupefying Act Dr. Stupid segments. And this is the actual VHS. Pretty much you know it's a Nickelodeon or Nick Jr. VHS, if it's orange. So they came up with that trademark, orange videotape. So that's how you can easily identify if you have a Nickelodeon or Nick Jr. VHS. It features 3 episodes from the first season, which include Robin Hoke, Ask Dr. Stupid, those 2 segments, Stimpy's Big Day, and The Big Shot. Stimpy's Big Day and The Big Shot are pretty much like kind of a put-together episode. They're kind of a 2-part episode. This is the back. Once again, this was, by the way, this was Nickelodeon's first video design when they started releasing videos. Most of all their videos look like this at first. At least the Sony Wonder runs. The ones by Sony Wonder look like this. But here's a little description pretty much of what the video is about. Some fans claim that Ren's faithful sidekick Stimpy is not dim-witted. Just misunderstood. Well, this collection of first season classics should straighten them out. Find out what happens when Simpy's passionately dopey poem wins 47 million contest and earns him a place on the Muddy Mudskipper show. Here the legend of Sherwood Forest, as only Stimpy can mangle it. And possibly 48 minutes. Good video. Good episodes on this video. And if you're a 90s nostalgic guy like me, you pretty much know about Ren and Stimpy. One of the first Nicktoons on Nickelodeon, along with Doug and Rugrats. And, really good video. The episodes are funny. They're funny as heck. But I gotta admit, the best video in this three-part collection has to be the stinkiest stories. It has to be the grossest and funniest. And I'll be doing a review on that. Nice vintage video that I found at a thrift store. There was actually four videos at the thrift store. Two of the volumes, two of these that I bought, and then one, Ren and Stimpy in Disguise, and they also had Ren and Stimpy the Classics. But, you know, I wanted to be nice, and I said, you know what, I was going to buy all four, because they were only like 50 cents. But I said, you know what, I'll be nice, I'll leave one. If another person wants to find Ren and Stimpy, they can. And so that's why I just bought the three. Once again, nice video, great episodes on here. They're funny as heck. And, once again, this is just Volume 2. I have Volume 3 and Ren and Stimpy in Disguise. And I'll get reviews for you for those in another video. There's really no way to describe the episodes. It's just, you gotta see them for yourself to believe them. They're funny, really funny. And while Ren and Stimpy was on the air, it did a nice job. So, once again, Stimpy's Big Day and the Big Shot is two-part episode about Stimpy getting famous over a poem. And then Robin Hulk is pretty much just like a fairy tale told by Stimpy to a Ren about what he thinks the story of Robin Hood is about. And then you got the two Axe Doctor stupid segments, which are when Stimpy comes out and he reads questions from his so-called fans and answers them in a stupid way. And that was the video review for Ren and Stimpy, the stupidest story. Hi everybody, me Bryson Booker here, and today I'm going to show you some of my vintage 90s toys. Most of them come from kids' meals. One of them actually is store-bought, but most are from the kids' meals. I found a great amount of these digging through some of my old toddler stuff that we were going to throw away. And I said, hey, I was like, I should take these and collect them. And so here's what I found. This first thing is a mini Mr. Potato Head from Burger King from 1998, I think. Yeah. It is a plush toy, and it actually used to talk, but the voice box in it is broken, and so it doesn't talk anymore, but it's a nice little plush figure from the Burger King Kids Club meal. This next toy is from McDonald's from 1992. This is the Tiny Toons series toy. This was the first series toys, I think. And this one is a car with Plucky Duck and Hampton the pig in there with his little he's running, so it's like a he's running with the car. They make quite a few of these. This is a nice toy. Next one is another one from Tiny Toons. This is Babs Bunny and her little musical car here. As you can see, this right here is like really dusty. this was supposed to be some CDs spinning around every time you would move it. This one doesn't move that much. But it's still a nice collector's thing. Tiny Toons was a good show. This is another one from Tiny Toons. This was the... They made a couple of these. The two-sided cars. This one features one of the Go-Go's, I think they call them. And, Montana Max. And, it's two-sided cars. One side, as you can see, Montana Max and his, money ride. And then the other side is one of the Go-Go's in a bathtub. Here's another one. I don't know the names of these characters. But it's pretty much the same thing. Flip car. You got the dog up here and some cherries. And on the flip side, you got a little alligator taking a bath. This next thing... is store-bought. This is a 1995 Electronic Kinect 4. And it's pretty much a miniature version of the game Kinect 4. It does work, surprisingly. That's how long it's been in storage. Start a new game. And you pretty much press this, the arrows to move. And then press center to make your, place your piece. And then it's the computer's turn. And it pretty much plays like that. It shuts off automatically when it's not in use. And it's a difficulty chart. Game and skill level. This next one is one of my favorites. It's the oldest in this collection. This one is from 1991 with the release of Back to the Future, and this is the car from McDonald's. I think this was released around the time, I think there were three Back to the Futures. This had to be Back to the Future 3 when it was released from 1991. And, this one's kind of unique because this little dome here, if you put it, if you move it so hard, this will spark. And it still sparks, surprisingly. See if I can do it here. It did spark, but I don't think you could see it. Alright, this next one is a pullback toy from a Goofy movie, 1995, I think. Yeah, had to be. This is from Burger King, and it's pretty much Goofy and Max on the... they're on skis on the water. And it's a pullback racer, so you just pull it back and then it goes forward. This next one is another one from the Tiny Toons collection. I'm not sure the names of these characters, but it's supposed to be other versions of Tweety Bird and Sylvester. And they're on tractor, and there's a little Sylvester there getting run over. This one's kind of nice. This one goes along with this one, and I think they're in. I think these three were all together in the collection. This next one is from a show that hardly gets recognized, but it still was a show. This is from 1997, Bruno the Kid. This was a cartoon that only didn't last long. It lasted from 1996 to 1997, and it starred Bruce Willis and this guy named Bruno, who was a spy. Kid spy, and he went on adventures. Once again, Bruce Willis played in this show. I'm not sure where this one came from. It's fairly big. But, Bruno the Kid. Good show. And the last one here I found, well, I really don't know where this one is exactly from. And I don't think it says the year on here. Oh, 1995. I'm not sure. If you guys know where this one came from, let me know, because I'm not really sure where it came from. Or who this character is. I'm having a feeling it was Batman, but no, I'm probably wrong. So if you guys know this toy, just leave a comment below. Maybe you all know who it is. But, yeah, that's pretty much it, my 90s toy collection. And thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. Hey, me, Bryson Booker here. And just one quick announcement before I get started. The following videos I'm going to be making is going to be about my music equipment. And so, as some of you don't know, I do play guitar at church. That's why I go, like, every Sunday. And, I just want to show you the equipment that I use. And one of them is, this PV Vintage 1980s or late 70s PV Studio Pro. Had this amp since 2010, bought it off of eBay for $45. And it's originally 20 watts, but the guy who gave it to me put a 70 watt speaker in it, so it does pump out some volume. I did not find an instruction manual for this particular model. There is a Studio Pro 40 and a Studio Pro 50, but for some reason, there's no manual for the original Studio Pro. And this is the original, has to be. There isn't any number 40 or 50 under it, so this has to be the original. Anyway, you got your control knobs here. I'll go through them. This is your reverb. The reverb does not work on this amplifier for some reason, but that's okay. I don't use a lot of reverb when I play. You got your high, which is also your pull bright, so if you press that in, it'll just sound, give you like a mellow tone, and if you click it out, then it'll kind of sound brighter. You have your mids, lows, your post gain, which is kind of like your volume, saturation, which is PV's patented, what do you call it? It's like a kind of a crunchy sound. You got that knob, and you got your gain knob. And you got two inputs, inputs one and two. I'm playing through a very old first act guitar. So I'll give you a demo on how it sounds. Let's cut out the lows. add more mids. And then cool bright is off. And then cool bright on. And then, once again, the reverb doesn't work. This is also your master volume. But it kind of doesn't work as a master volume because I use my post fader. It looks like some noise coming up from upstairs. But anyway, that's what that was. Alright, now it's time to add some gain. I love the crunch on this amp. Does get pretty loud, as you can see. Want some rock sound? Come on. I'm not playing hard enough. Just turn the gain up. And I don't want to crank the volume too high, as I don't want people yelling. So it does go very loud for what it is. And I'll try out input 2. People put 2 inputs on their amps, most of their amps, for high and low gain. So input 2 is low gain, so it doesn't give you that much gain than input 1 does. Kind of less gain. especially when you put a 70 watt speaker into it. I don't know what the actual speaker is inside of it. It doesn't have a name. It might be a PV. I'm not sure. But once again, Gradient. I had it since 2010. I use it like every Sunday, and I love the sound that comes out of it. And I hope you pick you up an old PV. Old TVs kick new TVs, but I mean, the old TVs, they rock. I like them. And I hope you enjoy. Thanks for watching. Come back next time for another music video.
Man, what a day. I need some replenishment.
Heck yeah. You know what? That delicious taste makes me want to dance. And it can only come from a delicious crush. Crush! Crush! Delicious! Refreshing crush! Drink it! Gotta drink it, man! Drink to leave it, man! Tastes delicious! Freaking freshing! Freaking delicious! I don't know what the heck this is, but I'm gonna sing it anyway! Gotta get some crush, man! Freaking delicious crush, man! Gotta try this crush, man! It's fresh and icy tasty! Gotta get this crush, man! Gotta get this crush, man! Crush! 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 Gotta taste it to believe it. Gotta try this crush. Yeah, gotta try this crush. Man, gotta taste it to believe it. Gotta try that crush. Yeah, gotta try that. Yes. Oh. Super tired, taking attention. No. Freaking drink it, man. Freaking drink it, man. Crush. Crush, crush, crush. Freaking drink it, man. Freaking drink it, man. Crush, crush, crush. Crush, 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 crush. Drink it.
And I'm running for president. Now, okay, I know the elections are held every 4 years, and it's not November, it's only May. Well, this is my channel. So, I'm running for president on my own time. Because if I'm president, it'll be the 90s every day. And the only thing that'll come on television is 90s shows. And not some stupid reality crap. And the only books we'll read is Diary of a Rumpy Kid books. Because those books are awesome. In The Simpsons, there'll be more than a television show. There'll be an entire movement. In school, forget about it. Because when I'm president, no school. Just fun, fun, fun. And some work. And gas prices, the gas prices will only be 50 cents. So vote for me for president, because only a moron wouldn't vote for me. Only a moron wouldn't vote for Bryson Booker. You know this is all fake, right? But seriously, if I was president, 90s rule!
Hey everybody, me Bryson Booker, and I'm gonna be stalking my dog. I know it sounds stupid, but I'm gonna do it anyway. I have a dachshund. It's a girl, and her name is Honey. In here laying on the couch. What's up with you? Wake up. What's going on? Stubborn. Come on. Tell the people what you can do. Pretty much just lay there. Okay. Up you go. Say hi to the people on YouTube. And she goes back down. Come on, honey. There you go. That's my dog, honey. Are you gonna do any tricks? Anything? Or are you just gonna lay there? Okay then. I'll make you do tricks. Don't you growl at me! You are one stubborn dog, you know that? Come on, honey! Show people tricks! Please! Do it for me. I'll give you a bone. Here, I'm gonna go get a bone. That is one stubborn little dachshund. Right there. Here's a doggy treat. This better make her get up. Okay, gonna try this again. Bear with me. Okay, honey, who wants a treat? You gotta do tricks first. Hey, honey, you want this? Huh? Oh, she wants the treats. You want this? You want it? Go get it. Ah, dang! You weren't supposed to eat it yet! Okay. You want this other one? Oh, you're still munching on that one. You are a slow. Okay, you know what? Take the rest. Here. Enjoy your little snack. You lazy dog. That's the only thing that can wake her up. And she's still stubborn. Well, that's Honey, my dog. I bet she'll never find the biscuit on her back. Yeah, there's no more. Sorry. Alright, I gotta end this video, so let's just end it with a bang. Yeah, there's your other treat. Enjoy. You better do some tricks. Don't you stick your butt out at me. Okay. Well, this is Honey. Honey, say bye to the people on YouTube. Another stupid video by me. Say bye. At least lick the camera. No, that's gross. Don't do that. Okay, I'll see you later.